All right, I have four more ankle exercises that I'm gonna give you guys today, so let's hop into it. What's going on, Pro Trainees? As you know, I am Coach Tony, and if this is the first time to our channel, make sure you subscribe, like this video, and comment below on what other content you want to see. But let's get into today's video. Quick disclaimer, I'm just a basketball coach. I am not a doctor or a physical therapist, so make sure you consult them before doing these exercises to help you get back on the court. All right, so this is the second video where we're gonna give you four more ankle exercises. But if you did not see our first video and you just injured your ankle, make sure you go check out our first video. I'll make sure I got a link in the corner of this video, because these exercises that we're gonna do today are for guys who've already kind of went through some rehab and they're a little bit harder. And now we're getting to the point where we wanna strengthen your ankle so that you don't continue to roll it when you get back on the court. All right, so our first exercise is gonna be part two of our last video where we did our ankle pumps. We're actually gonna do resisted ankle pumps and do the same series as we did in our first video. So with that being said, we're gonna elevate our foot again. All right, we're gonna make sure that injured foot is up in the air and our leg is straight. Now, we're gonna take a band, all right, and we're gonna put it around the ball of our foot, okay? Just like in our first video, if you don't have a resistance band, you can always use a towel, okay? And as you do this, as you can see how comfortable you are, you can always let go a little bit, or you can pull harder depending on how strong your ankles are. So for this first one, we're gonna do the same series as we did in the last video, all right? And it's gonna be up and down first. So I'm gonna pull that ankle back and then I'm gonna push it out against the band, okay? That band may move a little bit, but if you're going slow and controlled, you can always fix it, all right, in the middle of your set, okay? You just wanna pull it all the way back, push it all the way forward to really start strengthening that mobility back in your ankle. Once you get 10 of those, we're gonna do the same thing where we go left to right. Now, when we go left to right, we're gonna wrap the band around our other foot. So now both legs are straight. All right, I'm gonna make sure I'm sitting up nice and tall. And now I'm gonna go side to side. So I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna go out. Okay, same thing, bands on the balls of our feet. And I'm going side to side. Okay, this is part two of our ankle pump. So I'm going back and forth. Same resistance, okay? Working on pushing that ankle outwards. Once you get 10 of these, okay, now we're gonna switch our legs. So it's the same leg, but now I'm gonna put my other leg over the top, and now I can work on moving that ankle the other direction. Okay, so now I'm strengthening up being able to go on the inside of that ankle. And it's the same thing. I'm gonna get 10 this way, all right, 10 the other way. All right, and just working on the ankle. So if it's hard, you let it go a little bit. All right, if it's too easy, pull tighter. And do the same thing. All right, if you cannot do these exercises without your ankle going all over the place and you can't control the band, take the band off, do the movements without the band until your ankle is strong enough to do the movements with the band. All right, and this is part one of our four exercises for this video. All right, the next one we're gonna work on is our ankle flexibility. So you're gonna need a chair or you can use a wall. All right, how this exercise is gonna work is you're gonna start off by trying to find the range of motion that your ankle has. So let's say my injured ankle is my right ankle, so I'm gonna get close to the chair, and all I wanna do is see if I can get my knee to that chair. Okay, that's all I'm doing is just moving my knee to that chair as I keep my heel on the ground. If my heel comes off the ground, I need to move my foot closer, okay? Once I find that range, okay, let's say I back it up, my knee can still get to that chair without picking up my heel, then I found my spot, okay? That's as far as I can go. So from this position, all right, all I'm gonna do is stabilize myself against the chair or the wall, and I'm just gonna lean forward until my knee hits that chair, okay? Once my knee hits my chair and my heel stays on the ground, I'm gonna hold that for 30 seconds, okay? I'm gonna hold that position, working on getting that range of motion all the way into my ankle, okay? Keeping that heel on the ground, really stretching it out. After 30 seconds, I can bring my foot back. I can do the same thing. All right, shake it out a little bit and then go back into it. Keep that heel on the ground, tap my knee against the chair, and now I just hold this position as I'm working on that front ankle and the flexibility and mobility in that ankle. All right, the third exercise that's gonna help us strengthen our ankles is what we call single leg squats. So we're gonna keep our chair here. All right, I'm gonna get just a little bit in front of this chair, and I'm gonna get a nice even position, okay? Feet shoulder width apart. All right, I'm balanced, everything is good. From this position here, the ankle that is injured, all right, you're gonna keep flat on the ground and you're gonna lift up your other leg. From this position here, I'm gonna slowly go down to the chair. I'm gonna sit, I'm gonna relax for a second, and then I'm gonna pop right back up, okay? Working on strengthening that leg, strengthening your calf, and strengthening that ankle. Same thing, leg up in the air. I'm gonna go down slow, control it, relax for a second, and then we're gonna push up and through that ankle, okay? As you can see, you might be off balance, but that's where that ankle strength kicks in, and it helps you build up those muscles in your leg. So you can do 10 with the right leg and 10 with the left, even if the other ankle has not rolled. All right, the fourth and final exercise for our ankle exercise is what we call ankle clocks, okay? So you're gonna get a little bit of space, all right, and you're gonna put the ankle that is injured on the ground flat, all right, nice and even weight distribution, okay? From here, our other foot, we're gonna tap with our heel at every number on a clock. So just imagine a clock in your head. You got the 12 here, 1, 2, 3, all the way around. So I'm gonna stabilize myself on my right foot, and I'm just gonna tap forward on the 12 first, okay? Stand back up. Next, I go to the 1, I tap, I get to the 2, I tap. When I get to the 3, now I start to go the other way, and I tap all the way around, 4, 5, okay? I'm going all the way around the horn. 6, 7, just working on that foot. 8, all right, 9, all the way around until I get back to that 12, okay? And as your ankle starts to get stronger, you can start to step out a little bit further, all right? And to the point where you're actually working on the full range of motion and stabilizing your weight on that ankle, and then you gotta make sure you switch feet too. All right, that wraps up this week's video. If you want to train with us at home, we have a free 30-minute ball handling video. You can head over to perfectyourgame.com. But don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like this video, and comment below what you want to see in next week's video. I'll see you on Monday. Perfect your game. Peace.